court here for just a couple minutes. Thank you, Brandon, for your time.
Brandon, your legs look pretty lively in there in that workout. Are you planning on moving a little more than normal for this fight?
You know, I'm ready. That's all I'm going to tell you right now, that I'm ready. I've been training really hard. This time I'm more focused, dedicated to the boxing game. In the past, I was immature, you know, still a kid, you know, maturity didn't kick in. I was just being a dork, going with hardened balls. That's how I was doing it with. But this time, I'm more focused, more mature, and more dedicated to boxing, and I want to get back to the top, so I know what it takes to get there, so I got to do it now.
You addressed the critics heading into this fight, people that were even, you know, worried about you. But so what do you say now that the fight's on Saturday and you're in shape and ready to go?
It's all right, you know what I mean? They just add more fuel to the fire, so it's all good, you know. I don't really care about what critics say, because, you know, at the end of the day, that's what they are, just the critics, and it's not hurting me. I'm not bleeding from it, I'm not losing sleep over it, so it's all good. So, but right now, I can tell you right now, I'm in shape. I've been eating perfectly fine still up to date, and I'm on weight already, and I'm still going good, you know what I mean?
Are you still as hungry? Are you still going to be as willing to walk through the fire as you always have been?
That's, everyone knows the way I fight. That's my style. I walk through fire. And I walk through the brick walls just to whatever, to get the victory. So I'm ready, and we're just going to see Saturday night. Everybody's going to see the new improved Bam Bam.
But you don't think the wars in the past will affect your ability?
No. See, I'm going to say one thing straight. The reason why I look like shit in my last previous fight, because you gotta think about it. I went to wars after wars after wars after wars. That takes a toll on your body. If you don't fucking know, because you're not a fighter, so that takes a toll on your body. And that's why fighters, they get fucked, like, you know what I mean? They go after fucking fights after fights, tough fights after tough fights, wars after wars. And it happens. And, you know, and I realized it. So when I took a step back, and then I realized, you know what, my body was, and I wasn't doing it right. The dieting, the training, everything, I wasn't doing it right. I was doing the harder balls. But like I said, now I feel rejuvenated, I feel refreshed, I feel young again, and this is a different Brandon in the ring. You see the old Brandon that was when he fought Peterson, the old Brandon that when he won the world title against the Bosa. You see that guy coming back in life. So, you know, I feel good, I feel great, I feel young, I don't feel old, I don't feel like I'm war shot, whatever you guys want to call it. I don't give a fuck right now. Fuck it, like I said, I want to go out there, I'm going to show everybody wrong. Saturday night, I'm going to prove you guys wrong. And I'm going to love it. It's going to be a smile on my face when I win this fight. I put a middle finger up and say to everybody that doubted me and everybody that credited me, fuck you guys. That's what I'm going to say.
Hey, Brandon, what type of flaws would you say Danny Garcia has?
Now, you know, we can't say, you know what I mean? We can't say. Danny's a strong fighter, you know what I mean? He has powers in both hands. He's a great counterpuncher. The one thing I know that I like, that he doesn't move. He's not a runner. He likes to bang it out, so that's going to suit my style better. So we're ready for that, and if he does run, we're ready for a runner too. So I had all tremendous sparring partners. I had young guys sparring, so I'm ready, man. I'm just ready.
This is the best camp you've had in how many years?
Since the Peterson and Acosta, it's been a long time, man. I feel really great. I'm happy. Usually at this point, I wouldn't want to sit here and talk to you guys because I'm losing weight. I'm fucking sucked up. But you know, I'm good on weight already. I feel good. I'm ready to go.
How happy has that made this camp for you as well? Not having that stress. How much energy has that given you, seeing that you're doing things that you used to do years ago?
It makes the camp go much, much faster, much easier, because the fact that I'm still eating, I'm not grouchy, I'm not bitching at nobody, I'm not mad at the world, you know, I feel good still, so that makes it a 100 plus right there. So, not only that, but like I tell you, man, this time, I did it with the strength and conditioning too, so I was working all night long. I go to the gym at 12, I get down at 2:30, from 2:30, I go home, rest up, at 7 o'clock, all the way to 10 o'clock, I would do my strength and conditioning workout, so I'm in top shape, man, I'm a phenomenal shape, thanks to my boy, Junior, that was coming out to do the straight workout with me. Thanks to that guy for keeping me strong, keeping me me healthy, and Donald and Robert for providing with an awesome game plan, and we're ready for it.
So this is going to be very competitive in your eyes.
Yeah, it's really competitive. You can't count Danny out because he got that hook that he knocks out people with. So we gotta be ready for that, and not only that, but he got power in both hands, and he's a great counterpuncher, so he's tough. He got power, so we gotta be careful with that.
Molly, what does this fight at this point in your career mean for you? What does it do for you?
It brings a lot of joy back. The reason why I say that is because when I went Saturday night, I'm gonna look at you guys and smile. That's it. That's what gave my satisfaction. Not only that, but it means a lot to me because I still want to be a threat in the 147 division.
It sounds like you've got a chip on your shoulder. Like, is that something to motivate you?
So, like I said, thanks to you guys, thanks to everybody that counted me out, calling me a fucking cherry or whatever, Danny's a cherry.
You gotta
whatever.
Kick that ass, man!
I love it. You know what I mean? You're calling me a cherry and everything, man. So it's all good. So that's the chip I got because I wanna prove everybody wrong. Everybody wrong. That's what makes me want to do it more.
Hey, Brandon, you have fights like Pacquiao, Jeff Horn, where people expected Jeff Horn to not have a